chamomile. Mm-hmm. Mommy really likes chamomile tea, but chamomile is really good for treating a lot of different things.
Like stomach upset, your throat hurts.
Well, that's a lot of bugs.
Yeah, that is a fertilizer bucket. There's actually animal poop in it and water.
And then it helps the plants grow.
And that's what we feed to the plants. So we don't have to buy any fertilizer.
And chamomile, do you want to smell it? I think it smells good.
Yeah, it smells nice.
Do you want to, what kind of pollen do you think chamomile has? I bet it has yellow.
It has white too.
And white? You think white? What do you say?
It's a little yellowish green.
Yellowish green pollen. Very cool. So what? Let's talk about this.
We have this here is parsley.
So they
parsley you can eat just like that.
Do you want to take a little bite? Ask Miss Iris if you can pick a piece.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
They put parsley on your plate at dinner a lot as a garnish. But it's good with a lot of
yeah.
It's pretty strong. Does it make your palate taste clean?
Oh. I don't know.
I don't know. So what's next?
We have some hyssop here. And that was the bees really love that. They're going to bloom purple. And they're going to be full of bees. And then we're going to plant some more sage, which we haven't done yet. We have some in the pots over there.
Sage is a good disinfectant.
That will bug it too.
And it sometimes keeps mosquitoes away, doesn't it?
And this one? Smell this one. What does it smell?
Smells like lemon.
That's right, it's lemon balm. And that you can make into a tea. You can also eat it. But it smells really good. And the bees really like it.
Isn't that nice?
And that's really easy to grow, actually. So, let me have these two here.
It's like potpourri, yeah.
And here we have a lot of weeds that we still have to take care of, but what we have growing in between here, you can smell that and tell me how this is going. I'll tell you with your mom. If you can smell it, squeeze it between your hands a bit.
Yeah.
You want to rub it? What do you think it is? Does it smell like anything you're familiar with?
Uh-huh.
What?
Smells like inflammation.
Inflammation? Does it smell like a pickle?
Yeah.
So maybe it's... What's the first word before the sour pickles? Deal?
Deal.
That's deal?
Right.
Yeah.
That's the bill plant. And they're going to get really tall, and they're going to bloom nice and yellow. And actually, I just found out that this... What they told me it's called a sour clover. It's probably called something
sour
else.
Clover.
I'm going to have to look up what the scientific
Are those spiders?
Yes, this is spiders. That's right. What we're trying to do here, this was the bed that we used a lot last year. And so we double layered clear plastic on it according to...
Don't touch it.
Our 4-H office that came to our garden club and told us that that's supposed to kill off a lot of the bad bugs and the weeds. Not sure about the weeds. Because usually clear plastic draws the sun and makes them grow, but since it's double layered, it's supposed to kill it, so we'll find out. And of course, we have a lot of strawberries over on this side.
We have strawberries on our back porch, don't we? Yeah.
Yeah.
And actually, we have a strawberry garden.
Yeah, and they're all
well, they have a bigger one, don't they? I like the flowers on strawberries.
I don't see any strawberries.
So stand still and look down low to the ground. Don't walk in them.
I see some strawberries.
They're probably enough ripe ones. You can pick one and eat one if you want to.
Would you like to do that?
Sure.
Okay.
One right there. Get that one right there.
Yeah. Oh. All right, turn around. Show Mr. J your strawberry.
Go ahead and eat it.
Gonna eat it? delicious.
Of something else, because they really like to eat my strawberries too, and I would rather eat them.
You like garlic, don't you?
So this is a garlic plant, which you can, when this is small and young, you can actually eat these, and it's not quite ready yet, but we, yeah, this one is actually an onion. See the difference? This is a round leaf, squishy, and this is a flat leaf. So this is a green onion that you can eat actually like this.
Yep. Put some dill and some green onion in your scrambled eggs. Mm-hmm. It's yummy.
It sure is.
They have all the makings of a good breakfast, Maddy. They've got strawberries and herbs.
And we have a few radishes growing. There's a salad that's ready to bloom. And when it's blooming, we kind of let it go to seed and save the seeds.
So how do you save the seeds?
You just shake them out in the dish. You let them dry, nice and dry on the land. That's what I do. I mean, you can.
I want another strawberry.
Yeah, way over there.
Let's wait just a little bit.
We'll wait a little bit.
How do you store them? Once you.
Once you have them dried really good, I put them. I like if you have vitamin pills, but mm-hmm. You know, your little containers.
Yeah.
And anything that is where the mice can chew.
Okay.
Because if you put them in a little paper, you know, like plastic bags or paper bags, and you just put them. In a dark, kind of cool room, you want to keep them, or in a freezer.
Yeah.
To, you know, prolong the keep them. If you just put them in a dark room, cool room, your chances that mice come and bite you is, unfortunately, pretty good.
That makes sense.
We got some potatoes over here.
We're
going to
do tomatoes this year, Maddy, so let's pay attention to what she says about potatoes.
Did you already plant them?
No, we're going to. This fall, is that right? Or is
you don't have, they're not going to come to the next spring. I mean,
right.
If they come, they got, yeah.
Right, they're under the ground.
Potatoes is what you eat. So they're growing right at the end of the plant. There's going to be the roots of these plants. And the only thing we have to watch out for is if we don't get potato bugs on it, which is still bug free at the moment.
No carrots.
We have only one little carrot I saw over there. We haven't really planted them yet because now it's the wrong time. And before it was too, the frost has kind of prevented from growing a lot of things early this year. But what do you do with potatoes? You take a potato and you look that you have eyes on it. And then you just cut it into... I don't like to cut them too small. I want to say about chunks as big I want. Chunk, then it takes a lot longer to take off and to become nice and strong.
So is there a good time to plant them, or is it just that they only come up in the spring?
They freeze. I mean, if the frost comes, they'll die off.
Yeah.
They'll come back. Like this one died once, and then I covered them because we had these late frosts. They will come back, but they don't, you can't grow them throughout the winter.
Should we, would they do better in a container where they could be brought in where it's warmer, or?
The potato itself you can put in the ground. The only thing is it might get eaten by bugs.
Yeah.
It might get eaten by the moles and voles or whatever you have crawling around in your garden. Or if it's really wet in the area, they might just mush up. And
Mom, I want this up.
But we'll take it off in a little bit because it's pinned in.
And they just go bad.
Yeah.
So it's probably better if you can keep them in a dry, cool place, or don't even get them until the spring.
Okay.
I mean, if you have seed potatoes, you might as well, if you have to buy them, that's when they're selling them, it's in the spring. I just save, you know, the smaller ones, this size, or this one, actually this whole bed was usually, you rotate usually, unless you feed them really well, because they're heavy feeders. So anything like potatoes, cabbages, they're really heavy feeders. So you shouldn't plant them several times in the same spot. Well, I used this pot last year, and I didn't get them all out. And then this spring, I still dug them out. We could still eat them, but we had so many that I said, let's just plant them. So we replanted them. So we'll see. They look like they're doing pretty good. And I added all these wood chips, which brings nutrients in. And I added some fertilizer, so we should be actually doing pretty good. And since we're here, we're gonna go let the chickens out.
All right.